afternoon, would you like? For those that don't know me, my name is Motti Beck. I'm with Mellanox. And I believe that I'm the only marketing guy that wants to present here. So I'd like to keep it just technical if I can. And I wouldn't believe how well I am to see the room almost full, because a couple of years ago I came to a presentation that was only one guy, which makes it more interesting that he was the next speaker. And then he asked me to stay after that because he wanted to do that. So, thank you. So I'm going to talk about the unstructured data accelerator that we did. And the first question is actually why we did it. And the answer is very simple, because there is a need. For many years, enterprises, in most of my presentation, talked about enterprises, not about HPC. They were doing data analysis or business intelligence to understand the behavior of the customers. So it was done for many years. A typical example, like during the Christmas party or the Christmas period, about 40% of the revenue comes from this specific period. So they want to know exactly what is going on and to do business intelligence and to understand what is going on in the market and then forecast their selling the tactics accordingly. So this is a typical one, and so it's going on, it's pretty very tight to the effects, actually the revenue of the company itself, and company has put in a lot of effort and a lot of money to understand the behavior. So what makes the difference today? The difference is the big data, the availability of the huge amount of data that is available since the beginning of 2000. And actually, up to now, the industry considers the biggest sector is the IT, information technology. People started to think that actually the 20th century was only the technology, and the 21st is the information. So there is a huge amount of information in a digital way available for free, and companies that are not going to take advantage of it are going to lose money or are not going to be engaged. So, and another example is like the example that I put in here, like the idea to do a yield analysis of all the US, to put in all the electrical stations, like some kind of sensor that would be able to analyze and to do optimization all over. And of course, the amount of data that needs to be processed over time in a period of time is huge. You see, the market needs to be systems that will be able to manipulate the data and to come to the right results. And typical, for example, I took some example about the amount of data that is available today, and in purpose, I just took the statistics for 2009 Facebook, that over 2 years they went more than double their data. In 2009, they had about 350 million to data, more than 750 million users. But it's not just about social networking, it's also about high-performance computing, about 15 petabytes is available every year in the same project, and the industry again needs to come with a way to manipulate or process the data in a reasonable time frame and to get the results done. But it's also not just about the volume itself. This is a very famous chart in life. Basically show that it's not just about the volume. The volume is huge, but it's also about the speed that the data is arriving. The speed that there are so much data arriving today and it needs to be done sometime in the real time. And this why the system needs to be optimized and to be much more efficient compared to the previous one. The person ran very well, but they ran over the SQL, did very good job. SQL, you know, the limitation, that's a good job, but the data, the volume is also significant. Also about the normality of the devices that the data can come from. It's not just in the passage of newspaper and computers, today it's also about video, about the music, and about the computer itself, and so forth. And the complexity actually much higher than it used to be in the past, because it's not just about text, it's about video, it's about all the private information that the system is to end it and to get information on the data computer. So this is why basically the industry will need and will be what indeed the and the ways of the industry came is basically to follow the trend of serial topology. All of us here are old enough to remember the day that CPUs or servers were basically measured by qubits. There was not a long time ago, actually, the beginning of 2000 or 1984, that it was about AMD and the Intel was competing with the highest frequency microprocessor. But it wasn't able to scale because of the power consumption and the semiconductor value in the system. We know that it cannot run higher frequency in the CMOS without wasting too much power and too much power in microprocessors that scale. So then this is how the way to find it, you put it to scale, and then later on with multiple ports. And the trend continues today, and everything to fit with the new world, but every 2 months we can come to this moment of the process. And the computer industry has been followed it very much. Well, I believe that it was about 2003 that the supercomputer was built on the Unibank, which has the supercomputer was built using the Unibank connected server, a regular server, on the same server. Creating the first supercomputer, and it basically continued. You can later on the trend went into the enterprise industry. I believe that the Oracle was the first one about 2008, and what is starting to come is the Oracle app, the 11G, which is just one open cluster. So, even later on, and now you can see other technologies under deployment that have been. The kinds of application of the custom computer, the custom architecture, and the high performance, the manipulation of the big data basically follows. And the loop architecture basically is a parallel process. So we can go into that loop architecture and go into the visualization in the marketing world. The way that it was done in the morning by the UNC was talking about since a parallel process, taking the time, breaking it down to, I believe, 260 gigabytes, which is the standard, and starting working with the parallel. And the method running parallel then got communicated to the reducer. And through the, once the method started with the work, the price, the information due to the business itself, through the cipher operation, that every involved IO, the information goes into the reducer, the reducer, if you are to start and write and store, and you have to call for some relevancy, and then after that, after the reducer is being done, again in parallel, everything in parallel, the information after the reducer is being written into a disk, and then the duplication and redundancy and high availability. And we were able to identify that the special operation, the HDFL operation, are taking from what we call the burst characteristic. And the burst characteristic of moving data from one place to the other, this is the typical or the best example where RDMA can be used. Because RDMA is all about moving data from one place to the other without the CPU. This is one of the places that we identified Mellanox that we can improve efficiency of the loop architecture running over RDMA instead of TCP/IP. Remember that TCP/IP will not work. TCP/IP will work. But for scalability, running more jobs per second, RDMA is definitely much better than the actual results later. And this is one of the improvements that we did to the actual loop actually open source. So it's not just about to drive the amount of the The typical situation that a book is using is spread about 12 disks per server. And even if you use 12 disks of satellites, the performance is much higher than the 1 gig, the standard 1 gig that the industry is using today. So it's even more than 10. And if we go through a year later, when the SSDs are going to be used, and I believe that the next presentation of Dr. Kamban is going to be about SSDs, and I think that the is going to be about this later, then you need much higher than even the 40 gig per second. Yes, the SSDs today are pretty expensive. The SSD today is only from the perspective, it's about between $2.5 to $5 per gigabyte. Compared to the metric disk, it is about 5 to 6 cents. And the prediction shows that in about a couple of years, it's going to be about 50 cents for the industry today. And if you take into advantage the fact the power consumption, the reliability, and the overall efficiency, then definitely in a couple of years, you'll see a big deployment of these systems. Because they're much, much better on all the aspects, inside the plants, of course, compared to the SSD. So there is a need to improve also the speed, not just the RDMA. So this is another aspect of finding the better quality to connect the server to a good cluster over high efficiency. So it's doing so much, and I believe that this phone already knows all the controls fast already. So state non-block is not the best solution. Today, we are aware of the big corporations that put in place a good cluster that takes thousands of servers. And definitely, yes, you can go, by the way, to this TCP/IP with 1 gig. You can add more and more routers in the room, because we've done potentially the question is how well we can do, and if you can do it cheaper with 1 more cost per server. So, everyway, with your lower latency, the lower stability, the higher capacity, the lossless capability, and all of us are aware of, and of course, the offload using CPU, and today you start to see CPU servers with more and more cores that you want to use them for computation out there instead of running the PCP IP. For example, if I compare and just talk about it in the third year, we are, for example, deploying 40 gig. So you can come and say we need the 40 gig, actually. If you run 4 of 10 gig, then you are going to get the same. But running the 4 of 10 gig, you run 4,000 for this type of PCP/IP, using so much power from the CPU instead of running the gig. So everything is about efficiency, and definitely higher performance networking is going to be useful. So, and this is why, actually, we decided to come with the UDA. And they are going to be a plugin. Plugin means that we are going to take the Hadoop, the Apache Hadoop as is. And we are working with the Apache Hadoop community, first of all, to define the plugin itself, because there is nothing like that in the standard for the open source. Once we have the plugin, then the user will be able to choose whether you want to go with the Apache Hadoop as is, as for the vanilla Apache Hadoop, or we'll be able to plug our stuff, our plugin into it, that will be able to give you all the advantages that I just mentioned. There are a couple of others that they are going to do. So this is the structure that we are going to follow. Today, by the way, it's available. We are supporting the UDA through the Apache Hadoop 1.0 as it is. But it's not, it doesn't come as a plugin, it comes here, we have already integrated it, and if you want to test it and to benchmark, it's available today on our website. In the future, we'll probably want the plugin, and it's going to be ready, then we are going to put it together. Another thing that we do is because of the project, the characteristic of the infinitive or vertical way to run it over both of them. A lot of work that's being done today between disks memory. So when you are input in memory, you are basically cutting back 6,500 milliseconds to 500 nanoseconds. So this is going to be high numbers. So this is another thing that we make in the new change. But there are things we need that actually I didn't say, but it's in our study, allows to run the operation in memory. So the last thing that we need, that we change, I would say, the way that the net and the news are read. Very slow, like a serial word, the net starts from the reduce part, and in our way, we're doing more parallelism and enabling more pipelining between the two, using the ability of the exhibitor of the IBM to talk or to manipulate hundreds or thousands of sources at the same time. So what are the things that we do that are available for say one thing I want to mention that we work was done and recognize the Harvard University and what the work was done to meet them jointly and there is a white paper that was published and presented at the level of the people. So going into the software architecture, one of the most important things was that all the jobs running today over the cloud will be able to run at least without any modification with the cloud. So we didn't change the code. It's one thing which is written in code. So this stays the same, we need to put in the output on the server. Nothing was changed, so the same job will run again at least no modification of code. The plugin technique that we want to see, we use the Gemini, we can feel between Java. And then we modify the most important net output file to run over our net. And we do the same on the other side for the merger. We did the modified both of them to run over our net. And of course, we're running the operation over the manual adapter to support the array, whether it's a CD or working. And now maybe on the product or on the big test in the past. But giving you again, taking the advantage of all the benefits that we are good for seeing them and being able to work with the time and looking much for it. So, if I need to start to describe a little bit together what we did, so in the net itself, we didn't touch. This is the net operation we did touch, it's still the same as the let's call it the vanilla. The TCP did that. Today, on the vanilla algorithm, the merge actually starts depending on the parameter that you define to the system, but then start while the net is still running. And it starts to do merging between the different cross files. And start to do a little by little until it ends, and only at the end of the merge, the reducer starts to work. And this, again, this the way that the TCP and the TCP allows it to work because of this one, the characteristic of the TCP. In our case, we actually waited until all the nets, all the methods, stop to work or finish their work. And then we can take one by one the results and manipulate all of them. For example, if you are looking for A, all of them, you are taking all the files, all the A's, and it can be sort of thousands of them. But I mean, they can end it in memory and start to do the shuffle immediately after that. But this allows to do the reduce at the beginning and not to wait because we are already the initial results. Of a specific server that we're looking for compared to the other. So, even if I go forward and you will see that from the ship to do with the insertion part of the group, on the left side, you will see that there is an overlap between the simple utilization when it has the matter and the reducer. So, yes, it's fine, but it takes much longer compared to the work that we're doing, and basically there is no overlap at all, but it takes a shorter time. So this is where we started before, and we use the graphs for the benchmark, and we understood at the beginning only in 12 months of the single amount of energy of transport to move to one program. And we were able to accelerate our data, so taking the use of time of 20 gigabytes with four disks of the same frequency per second of the year, we were able to accelerate the work from basically to cut the time by almost 50%, 45%. So 50 marketing ways. So this is the end there. It's available today. We can donate the patient to the officers community. This is our intention. But then, of course, there are processes we need to go through with the plugin ability. And then we will begin our manufacturing. And I think that this one already discussed. About the blueprint is that it's using our gear, what we call the GPI, so you can take the same actual blueprint, the vanilla one, only for the 10, 40, you see the band, we are the other design, I didn't know the design for the compare, and the size of the custom for the big power is 18 points. We are going to stay with the right completely required for 40. So I think this will be able to test the results of this. So basically, it's just my presentation. Yeah, so. Yeah. I don't have the time because we are